Howdy, everyone.
Hey, everybody. Today, we want to give you a full tour of our home. That means everything that we carry in this Nobo trailer. Now, we have been living in our tent for almost a year now. We're just a month shy. If you're new to the channel, I'm Kellie.
I'm Cody.
And we have been married for, we just had a wedding anniversary, 13 years.
Oh, yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Happy wedding anniversary.
And we decided that today we need to share with you guys everything that we carry in our trailer and that we use on a full-time basis. So let's get started.
Jumping right in with this tour is our vehicle that we pull everything with. We bought this back in 2010. It is a 06 Hummer H3. We kept this and went with this whole rig because this has already been paid for. So we had no debt in this, so we just went with this and kept going with it. And we love this thing. It's got 273,000 miles on it, still ticking. Does have some problems here and there, but what do you expect with something that old?
And it's literally still ticking. Back here is where we store stuff, obviously. We took the back seats out and we built a platform to go here. If you want the build of the platform, we made a video specifically on that, so we will list it in the description below. But this allows us to store more things here. We don't have the bulk of the seat, the width right here. We can store our water jugs. We have two water jugs that we refill with filtered water. We'll get to that later. We have all of our lights and electronics, small electronics, stored down here. Here I have a couple of hats that sit on top of our bathroom box is what I'm going to call it. It has anything from fingernail clippers to toothpaste, toothbrushes, anything you would find in a bathroom in the cabinet is pretty much going to be in this gray box here. Next to the gray box, we store all of our electronics, which would be the cords to charge things with. We have our GoPro, cords to charge the power banks with, the drone.
And we like having it here for quick access because sometimes we might be driving down the road and we just need the cameras immediately and we can just reach directly from behind, grab them, and go.
Now, if you're looking back here and you see a couple of things, I always carry my essential oils. These two tubs are for underwear. One's Cody's, one is mine. This blue bag over here, which is usually in the tent, but I did not set up the bedding for the full bedding because I wanted to show you what we're actually sleeping on, not the sheets or the pillows. So I did not put that out. These are just pillows that we put on the bed. This is how we store all of our clothing items. So we each have one. This is my closet and Cody's closet, and in here is all of our clothes. I mean, everything from winter clothes, summer clothes, in between. It is all stored in our tubs.
And we actually have a few dress clothes so we can go out to places and look decent.
A lot of times we do visit cities and we camp somewhere within the city or on the outer limits and we can go out to eat. So we do have some clothes to look decent when we go out to eat.
And the way that we store these, if you're wondering, is we roll everything up like that and we have to stack all our clothes on top of each other. And things that we don't wear most often, it usually gets rotated. Winter clothes stay on the bottom, summer clothes on the top, because we're coming to summer. Once we hit winter, the summer clothes will go to the bottom and the winter clothes will go on top.
Which, it really, it's hard to keep track of because last summer we basically spent in winter temperatures. So it's just really weird. You have to just go with the flow on that one.
Since Kelly just got done talking about the pillows, let's talk about our two sleeping quarters. One of our first tents that we have, we do have two tents, is we have this 10 by 10 ALPS mountaineering tent. We have a full detailed review on both tents that we own. We'll put those in the link below. But the reason that we have this tent is for when we're in a small area, or if we come to a spot that we're only camping one night, we can set it up. And it also holds heat better. So we have a Mr. Buddy heater. So when the temperatures are really, really cold out, we can put the heater inside of here. And it, because the rainfly goes so far down, this actually does a great job of holding the heat for really cool temperatures. What would you say, about 30 degrees, 28?
We've been in the
20s in this and felt perfectly fine with our Mr. Buddy heater. When we go to places where we're gonna stay longer, we have a much larger tent. It is a 14 by 10 monster. It's a cabin tent by Browning. We just left Fort Pickens and we put this whole thing up. We put all of our closets in there, our tubs, and just stayed in that. We had a lot of privacy, a lot of room to walk around. If there's bad weather, we will also put up both tents and sleep in this tent over here and put our bedding in there, and we will put all of our other stuff. So if it's raining all day, I can sit in here and edit. Kelly can work out, watch TV. We'll put this little lounger in there and we'll relax just like it's a living room and spend our day in there if it's bad.
Come on inside and I'm gonna show you what we're sleeping on. Right when you walk in, if you notice in the corner here, we have a boot tray. So we do not wear any of our shoes in the tent. We take them off and we set them on the boot tray. At night when we're sleeping, we set them on the boot tray. That way critters don't get in our shoes at night if we have to step out and go to the restroom. But I specifically do not have any sheets on the bed because I wanted to show you what we're sleeping on. I know that you've had a lot of questions about it. So let's just go over it really quickly. We have two separate cots. Now, a lot of people are really confused as to why we have two different beds and we're not sleeping on the same bed together. We push both of these cots together and the mattresses butt up to each other and it forms one single bed pretty much. Now, they do make double cots, but what I do not like about them is the bar that's in the center. Now, it might work with these mats. Whenever I looked at them, we were not using these mats. We were using something totally different, but we have not gone that route. We're pretty happy with this setup. It's just like a regular bed for us. So this cot is from Bass Pro. It's the Bass Pro Eclipse cot. We like this cot because of the mesh. It helps it to dry quicker. Now, if we've been sleeping on these cots, even just one night, they will retain moisture. So the fact that there's mesh here, this doesn't retain the moisture. It's this thick canvas part here. And we just have to let it dry. It takes maybe 10 minutes to dry. We have to remove this off of it and all the bedding when we pack up to go. It takes about 10 minutes to dry. Now, if the whole thing was this blue canvas stuff, it takes a longer amount of time to dry. And it also will hold smell after a couple of years. That is why we got rid of our old cots. They look pretty narrow, but once we put these mats on them, they're white, at least a little bit wider. And it's extremely comfortable. A lot of people, they think that camping is just uncomfortable and roughing it. But we have come to find out that these beds are more comfortable than any bed we've ever slept in. We have been to a couple Airbnbs, my parents' house, and these beds are still our favorite, most comfortable beds.
Here's the sad thing. At her parents' house, it's our old mattress. From our old home, yeah. And we took it there, and this is more comfortable than our old mattress, yes. That we loved.
That is, when we got rid of it, it was basically a year brand new. Now let's get on to the padding. This is what makes this bed so much more comfortable. This is a 3-inch memory foam pad. It does roll up, and it fits into these bags. This is the brand here, Willpo. It is from Amazon. Do not know why that is the name of it. I have looked it up and there are other brands with different names, but it is the exact same thing. So it doesn't have to be the Willpo brand. If you look it up and maybe that one's out of stock, it's going to recommend you a different one that looks exactly like it. And it is exactly like it.
I'm 6 foot and this, look at that.
Yeah.
Is that not nice? I'm 6 foot tall. Yes. Oh.
And then once we push them together, the mats touch each other. And if you notice, there's like a Velcro here on the side and they kind of just stick together.
Matter of fact, go ahead and push them together so we can show.
So whenever, this is what we usually do after I put our sheets on, which I should just get one big sheet. I have two twin sheets and that's normally, but this is what we do right here. That's it.
The other thing we do is we always carry these wood shims with us. This is the one thing that every single camper has to deal with. It doesn't matter if you have an overlanding vehicle, an RV, or a camper trailer. You have to level out where you sleep. Almost everything that we have, we don't have to level out except for these beds if they're uneven. So I bring these wood shims, and this is the other reason we like having two separate beds, because they both can have different grounds beneath them, or pot, or you know, like little dips or angles, and each one is completely different. So it makes it easier to level out both beds together, because Kellie's might need four boards and mine might just need one, and we just throw them under the leg like that.
Now what I put on top of these is we just have a fitted sheet and then a flat sheet. We also have our each have a sleeping bag, and then we each have a very warm blanket in the event that it's really cold outside. We are very warm while we're sleeping.
We haven't been uncomfortable to sleep when it's really cold out. The part that's miserable when it's super cold out is getting out of the tent. That's the part that's always been rough. When we first started this journey last year, one of the things that we started missing a lot was comfort. And we know we do have quite a few things, but we don't have a home. This is our home, and you want to be comfortable every once in a while. So to make it easier for me to edit, Kellie was very nice and found this online. And it's the zero gravity chair, which I can put in here, put the laptop here, and work away and be comfortable versus being uncomfortable sitting in a chair all day. I don't always sit in this tent. This is just if there's bad weather. I'll set this here. Like we say, Kellie might set up a lounger or something in here, and we can spend the whole day in here like it's a living room. Look how much room there is in, with this bed. So if you take these beds out and you have them in the other tent, this feels like a living room to us, especially if we add our heater in here and it's a little chilly outside, or with our new fan.
Like Cody said, this is big enough for us to work out in. So I think the next thing we need to show you is our gym. But before we get to that, I'd like to say that we do work out about 4 days a week. And if one of those days that we need to work out and it's rainy, we can come in here and we can work out. I have done cardio workouts in here. We've weight trained in here. I've done yoga in here. So this tent is definitely a lifesaver, living on the road full time and being able to continue our activities to stay healthy and strong.
And just to give you an idea, this, I'm 6 foot. What is this?
I think it's a 7 foot ceiling.
7 foot ceiling? So, I mean, we've got this much room up. We can't, you know, do anything super crazy, but we can still get a workout in. When we go in the tent, we usually don't have this tarp. The reason we have the tarp down is so that we don't get all our equipment dirty. But when we put this in the tent, we usually just take this pad, these dumbbells. There's Selectec dumbbells that can go from 5 to 52 pounds. And it's enough weight for us because we know there's other options for weight training, but this is one thing we didn't want to give up. We love weight training. So we found these, we ordered them, they fit in the trailer, works out great. We also got this bench from Flybird. And you're wondering, where do you store this? We store this right in front of our little closet tubs in there, and it folds up flat. It's the reason we got this. It can go flat bench all the way down. And then you just pull out a pin, bam. And it stores right in there, disappears. I don't know how Kellie found this because I looked forever trying to find one of these things. Whenever we work out, I also will probably go on a run or mountain bike ride. Kellie doesn't like running so much, so she'll do more cardio with YouTube.
I like to do cardio HIIT workouts, so it's like short interval workouts with a rest in between. And I have a lot of YouTube channels I watch, but if we're primitive camping and we do not have Wi-Fi, I just kind of make up my own thing. I have a little booklet of all of my workouts that I do. I kind of just jot stuff down and make stuff up. I made that booklet probably 6-7 years ago. Been doing that for a long time.
And I've actually gotten to the point that if I can't run or we're in bad weather, I've started doing these workouts with her, and it's fun being able to do something together. But now that we're talking about us working out, you know, you get sweaty and you get dirty. And we do this every day, so we have to stay clean.
For us to stay clean, we have a portable shower system. Now, this is the Joolca hot water system. If you want the full review on this, we will list that in the description below as well. It also doubles as a sink to wash dishes.
This is the shower head that will go inside the tent.
And with the shower is a two-room shower tent. So one room is to shower in. You can see that there. You can hang all your soaps and stuff.
And this hangs right up here on this hook and shoots straight down for you so that you can have a shower.
And then on this other side here, it's just nice to have a separate side that's not wet with all the water to get dry, put your lotions on, and get dressed before you hop out. So this has become very handy. I told him there was no way I could go on the road full time without having a shower. It's one thing to not take a shower if you've just been doing nothing all day, but like we said, we like to work out at least 4 days a week. We like to do a lot of activities like kayaking or mountain biking. And if you do those activities, you know, you get really super sweaty. And so we like to go to bed clean. And I would say at this point, we have not missed a day without a shower. So that's been really nice.
If you're wondering about showers or where we get our water from, what we really strive to find is a water source like a clean creek. Arkansas's mountains are great for it. Colorado, Wyoming, Montana. We haven't had any problem finding creeks up in the mountains to be able to pump water from. And that's what the system does. You have these hoses right there, and you just take this little filter and you throw this with one of those hoses attached out in the water. You have a pump and it pumps water into this system, turns it on, propane runs this. And to power it whenever it's doing that is we use this little Four Patriot power bank here because it's lightweight, and you plug it into the 12 volt, powers it right away. And when that thing starts dying and we have plenty of sun, do this solar panel. But if we can't find good water, and it happens quite often, we have another option.
That leads us to one of the main reasons that we bought this trailer. So this is a No Boundaries by Forest River 10.5 2019 trailer. We love this because it has a 30 gallon water tank. So if we were not near a water source, we can have a shower. It has a port here. This hose came with it, which we also use to pump our fresh water that we filter to drink. Then we hook a whole system up to it and we can have a shower. Now, it's not a full shower where the water just runs. You do have to get wet, turn it off, soap up, rinse it off, turn it off, because we don't want to waste water, because we'll also use it to wash dishes. Now, we do carry another jug. This is a 6 gallon jug from Walmart that we fill with water. This is a lot easier just to quickly wash your hands. If you're brushing your teeth, you need a little bit of water to get your toothbrush wet. That is a lot easier, so we still carry that around. So all in all, we have 36 gallons of fresh water that we carry with us.
And that 36 gallons of fresh water can last us a solid 2 days out in the wilderness with having a shower. Both of us having a shower each, washing dishes. But this is the water jug that she's talking about. Aquatainer. Works out very nicely.
Another reason why we bought this trailer is because of our refrigerator. Now, this is a Dometic refrigerator. It can either be a refrigerator or a freezer. We just have it set at 32 degrees and it will still hold some of our frozen items like waffles. Right here used to be a 2-burner propane stove. The burners only were 6,000 BTU, so we ripped that out and we put in a butcher block, which I love because if you watch our channel, I love to cook, and this is great for cutting up vegetables, prepping, anything like that. Now, since we ripped this out, we did it because we already had an excellent cooker. This is the Camp Chef. It's a 2-burner stove, 20,000 BTUs per outlet. And that, if you cook, you know that you can't really get much done with 6,000 BTUs. I think it took 30 minutes to boil water the first time we tried. This just works a whole lot better. Now, if you want a full review of my kitchen, we did one a couple of months ago. Not much has changed since then. We'll list that in the description below so you can check that out. Under the butcher block, I can also store my cutting board, my tubs with my utensils. We've got some paper towels, a lighter, just a couple of things like that. The next thing we really love about this trailer is the spice rack or pantry. Now, I have a lot of stuff because I love to cook, so this is basically a spice rack. It holds some Ziploc bags and trash bags, but basically all of our spices and teas. Next, we have a tub down here. You will always see this out because this holds pots and pans, plates, silverware, cups. So you can watch the kitchen review, and that will be, I'll show you all of that stuff in that video, which I said we'll list it in the link below. Now, a lot of people are questioning, you know, why do you have the trailer if you don't sleep in it? Well, you just saw all the stuff that we have, and so we had to have somewhere to store it, to move it along with us, and that is why we have the trailer. Most of the stuff is pulled out from here. As you can see, it is all just storage. We have to have somewhere for our bikes. We like to keep our bikes inside because being on the road consistently and driving down dirt roads, maybe driving somewhere where there's been salt on the road and weather, your bikes, they will tarnish. They will not last very long. They will have to consistently be cleaned before you ride them. And this way, there are already cleaned and ready to go, and we can just pull them out when we're ready to ride, and we don't have to worry about any of that.
And it reduces on maintenance costs because cassettes and stuff will start corroding, and you'll end up having to pay hundreds of dollars to repair things on your bike.
All in all, it's fine if you're just gonna, you know, store them in your garage and then take them out, you know, for a 1 week trip or something. That's not a big deal, but consistently being on the road, it's just smarter to have them packed away. This tub right here is my pantry, I'm gonna call. It holds all of our food. It's pretty low right now, but I need to go store it. But it does hold all of our food. Anything you would see in a pantry is pretty much here. Now, another thing we like about this trailer, it has all these nice little bungee storage areas. So we have our hoses up here. This is all of our stakes and soaps and cleaning sprays, which I use a natural cleaning spray, which is Thieves by Young Living. Also try to use any kind of natural soaps. And then down here is just stuff we don't need all the time. Like we have tarps for rain, walls that go on our 10 by 10 canopy, which we'll show you that as well, that stores away because we only really need those when it's raining.
And then right here, there's tools that we need quick. We have our hammer quickly accessible. We have our shovel for, you know, digging cat holes or working with fires. And then of course, when we need to cut wood, we have our hatchet. Other things I like to have easily accessible for activity purposes is all our fishing gear. Like all our fishing poles will go right here. If you can see them sitting, it's kind of dark, but they're sitting in this track on this bike rack that my dad and I built. So if you want to know how we built that bike rack, we'll put that in the description below.
Right here, this yellow lid tub holds all of our bedding. So the blankets I talked about are in here. We also have towels. You can't forget to have towels when you're showering. We have bath towels. We have hand washing towels, hand drying towels. We have any kind of towels you can think of in here. I guess I can just open them. And then we have two beach towels. So we have our sheets, regular towels, you know, dishwashing towels, and our blankets. These are the warm blankets I was talking about. So that all stays in here so it can stay nice and clean. And then over here, we have more bungees. This holds cordage. We have a broom and dustpan, an extension cord. These are my shoes on this bungee. And right here is going to be Cody's shoes down here.
Because mine are dirtier and I got bigger feet.
They're bigger.
So I'm going to crawl in here and show y'all the front of the trailer. In the front of the trailer, we put everything that we don't need to get to all the time. This is a laundry tub. It has everything you need for a laundromat. I think we do laundry about once a week. We'll go to a laundromat. Yeah. Anyways, up here, we'll store our Mr. Buddy heater and the big fan. So if you watched our vlog last week, we just got this new fan from Lowe's. This is a blower fan. It's working out really nice. This is also the reason we have the extension cord. We'll store paper towel, toilet paper up here, and Kellie's dress shoes. So she has two pairs of dress shoes for going out, and they're still in their boxes. So we put dress shoes in there. And then in this closet, we put things that we really don't get to because it's kind of a pain in the rear end to get to this one. Everything's in here, but we have all our kayak camping gear, so when we get ready to start kayak camping, we have all this in here, plus Kellie's favorite tea. We got tons of these. I don't know why, because I haven't even gotten
I'll say
yet.
Okay, so I'm loving this tea, and I could find it in Little Rock in the stores. Now all of a sudden in January, I couldn't find it anywhere. I couldn't find it no grocery store. So I was like, they're pulling this off the shelf. I'm just gonna have to go online and order it. So I did go to Amazon and I ordered two cases of it. I did give some of it away, but I kept it was a lot, but I mean, I just didn't know what to do. I was really like panicked for a minute there.
We have MREs and little oatmeals, so if something ever happens and we need backup food for any reason, we have enough backup food, like little meals like this, plus
for a week, and that's it.
Yeah, for a week right now, plus these little MREs like this, just for a week right now. So if we need to go kayak camping or do something, we have these already, but we can restock our little food emergency area.
Yeah, in an event, we have been picking up little MREs and the oatmeals and stuff like that when we see them, and just keeping them on hand just in case, because you never know. We cannot store a lot of food, obviously. We don't have a house, so we try to just get little MREs like that just to have on hand just in case.
And that's also why I'm trying to learn how to fish better and got a mushroom book. Speaking of cooking, this is also where we store Kellie's Dutch oven and pressure cooker in here. So we just store all this in here. It gets dirty, you know, black soot from fires, but that's where we put this stuff. It's out of the way, it's in the back of the trailer, and usually everything's already out of the trailer. I've never needed to get to this and everything be in the trailer. Never has happened. I don't see it happening. The last thing that's in here is this awning. This is a 10 by 10 awning. We have this, if you notice, we use this on the beach quite often. We also have it because our batwing awning that came with this trailer does not hold rain.
Very, it does hold rain.
Yeah, it does hold rain. So it doesn't hold up in rain very well. So we'll put this out in place of the batwing awning and butt it up right over the bag. When the batwing awning has been put back in the bag, we'll set it right over that, butt it up right next to the trailer, put those extra walls that Kellie was saying that we have on it. They're little 10 by 10 walls. It's an Ozark trail brand. And it works great for bad rain weather because we don't want to cook inside of the big tent. We still want to cook out here next to Kellie's kitchen, which that leads us to going back outside to show y'all the batwing awning. This isn't a reason why we bought the trailer, but it's a pretty cool bonus.
So this is our Rhino Rack brand batwing awning, and this does serve a very good purpose for shade. It's a darker canopy and it's thicker, so it does block out more light. And we recently got walls that go on each side, and we'll throw a clip in of those walls. We don't have them up today. We don't really need them, but the walls serve as privacy. So if you are in a RV campground, which we try not to go to those campgrounds, but sometimes you have no choice, they're really good for privacy. They're also excellent wind blockers. I cannot wait to test those out when we had high winds. We didn't have those at the time, so we just kind of had to deal with it. But they're excellent wind blockers.
When we have plenty of sun, there is another benefit. We still have shade from this, but we can recharge our trailer. And that leads us to the solar panels that we have for this trailer. This solar panel is a 130 watt Go Power brand that hooks up, and we plug it in right here. Bam. This will not run the 110 volt. You have to hook up the shore power, which we have on the other side. It's a 30 amp hookup. So when we're at campgrounds, we can hook that up. It recharges our refrigerator, and then I can plug all our electronics in there and charge. But whenever we're out in the national forest, this will run the lights and the refrigerator. So if we are out in the national forest and we're needing to charge things, we do have a power bank for that. Four Patriots sent us an 1800 watt solar power bank. This big old behemoth right here. Look at that thing. And it is recharged with this solar panel here. We'll plug in our laptops, all of our electronics. We can charge everything from this, and we can run that new fan that we bought from this unit if we're out in the middle of nowhere and it's so hot we can't sleep. Because when you can't sleep because you're hot and you're sweating, well, you just can't sleep. It's not gonna, you just ain't gonna sleep.
We have two batteries at the front of the trailer, and our trailer can go for, I think, about four solid days before we lose a lot of power, and then the refrigerator doesn't want to stay as cool as it should. That's when we know that we get the solar panel out, or if there's too much tree canopy and we can't charge, then we'll just hook it up to the truck. And once we hook it up to the truck and we're driving, it recharges the batteries. So then that gets us to our next spot, and then we can either put the solar panel up or just stay there for a couple of days. Now, we talked about being comfortable with the lounger and Cody's zero gravity chair, but we also have two regular chairs that we sit in when we're eating or just, you know, hanging out. These are from REI. They're the old school fold-up chairs like this. And we find these to be way more comfortable than the bag chairs. We had the bag chairs for years. And then I thought we were in an REI, and I was like, oh, cool. I was just kind of messing around. Sat down in one of these chairs. I was like, no, we have to get these. Because you just feel more, your posture's better. You're not sunk down. Very, very more comfortable to sit in when you're doing this full time. And since we're talking about that, let's go ahead and talk about our table. We have two tables. This one we use to put our water jug on, or we'll eat with this table. And this is just a little $20 fold-up table we got at Walmart. This table here is the Lifetime brand. We recently got this table at Home Depot. The reason I like this table better is it has three levels that it raises up to. And if you can see me standing next to it, it raises up tall enough like a counter in your kitchen. It's not super low and I'm not like bending over prepping food and stuff like that. So I have a lot of food prepping space, a lot of places to get dinner ready because I love to cook. So it's one of my favorite things to do and I'm glad that I'm still able to do that.
And speaking of cooking, the way that we power the gas stove in the propane heater is on the front we have two 20 gallon propane tanks, and we need these. We need this much propane. The reason why is we use it a lot. Especially if it's cold out, we'll use the Mr. Buddy heater directly to this too. We have a hose for it. I'll unscrew this, I'll pull one off at a time, and we'll use one until it's empty so that if we're out in the forest, we know that, hey, we still got one full backup, and when we're in town, we can refill this up. I think we go through one bottle when it's cold out. Okay. Alrighty then. We'll go through one. It was just a would-be angel print.
I don't care, they're big.
We'll go through one bottle of propane probably every 2 weeks during the summer, and during the winter it might be a week and a half when we're having to use the heater, wouldn't you say?
Yeah. And here are our two batteries right here.
And if you notice on the top up here, we have our kayaks mounted. Whenever we come to a campground and this is already set up, we'll remove this from the top of here, and on the top of the H3 we have kayak mounts, and we also have two bike rack mounts in case we need to leave this somewhere. We can just put it all up here and take it to wherever we want to go, and it doesn't make it where we have to rehook up the trailer and take the trailer somewhere, because there's a lot of places we can't take the trailer to do activities. Parking for mountain bike trails, sometimes there's not enough room, or if you're at a kayak launch on a river, it might be a real small area. We came across that. Since I'm up here, you might be wondering, what is this antenna right here? This antenna right here is a Wii Boost. We use this to amplify our cell phone signal. So when we want to upload our videos or make a phone call, if we just have one cellular bar, we can actually increase it probably threefold with this little Wii Boost antenna. And there's an antenna right next to our seat. Our phones will receive that and amplify it. It doesn't create a signal out of thin air, it just amplifies the signal that already is there. On the back of the H3, I forgot to cover this, but we do have this little backpack looking thing. This is for us to tote trash away from our campgrounds when we're dispersed camping. We can put probably 3 or 4 trash bags in here. It gives us enough room to also pick up litter that we might find out in the National Forest or BLM lands. And that way we don't have to put it inside the trailer, and if there's some kind of liquid or something, it drips in there and doesn't drip in the trailer and makes everything nasty.
Something else I just remembered, I forgot to show you, is where do we put our dirty clothes? We have this handy little tub right here, and it fits our dirty clothes. Now, once this thing gets full, that's when we know it's time to do laundry. There's been times that it's been so full. I'll show you where we store it. It rides here. There's been times it's been so full that we've just started piling like towels and stuff on top of it. So this is when we know when this is full that we need to do laundry. Not necessarily are we out of anything, we're just out of room to store the dirty clothes. But when we're driving, this tub rides right here on top of my food.
A common question that we get a lot when it comes to our setup is, how long does it take us to set up and break down camp? And usually with a 10 by 10 tent and just setting up our kitchen and shower, it takes 15-20 minutes for us to set it up. And then you add about 5 extra minutes when we do the large tent.
Sounds about right.
And it's about the same amount of time for us to break down. Now, for filming us setting it up, that increases the time.
Mm-hmm. Anything we film increases time.
Well, I hope we covered all y'all's questions.
Now, remember, if you want any detailed information on most of this stuff, we have done an extra video on that, and we'll list it in the description below. To find the description, you hit that little arrow. It's going to drop down a box, and they should be right there. But I think I need to put sheets on the bed, and you want to try to get a workout in?
I like it.
Sounds like a plan.
We'll catch you on the other.
See ya.